I titled this Stars as Scar. No, Scars as Stars. There you go. Because, you know, we were repairing denim that had holes in it, like, it's kind of wounded up. What that reminded me of was actually my dad's scars. He's of the last generation in Taiwan to have had polio before the vaccine. As a kid, he fell a lot because his legs weren't good. So a lot of scars on his legs. For him, the way to deal with that was to be really like extroverted and precise. Like, he felt like he could be like really good at something, right? So that he wouldn't have to feel as badly about having a disability. And he actually spent a lot of time with my grandmother. I think in the first few years of his life, she had to carry him on her back, like everywhere to the doctors and everything. So they became really close. She basically took care of the extended family that lived with them in Taiwan, and she would support the family with a sort of home industry of making clothes, or I think she had a knitting machine. He'd tell me about how it was very loud, you know, the knitting clack clack of that machine. So my parents met in pharmacy school in Taiwan and moved to the States. They immigrated over in the 80s. But I can imagine that not knowing the language and moving to a new place, like any sort of like attempt to be good at what you do or like always look nice, always know how to take care of yourself, like those things are not always attainable in a new place, right? All this made me wonder about how I was shaped by my family background. Some of their emotional scars became mine, I think. But this, I think, also attributes to some of my artistic ability, which is, you know, attention to detail and precision. And I like to think that I inherited some of the handiness of both of my grandmothers. Many of members of my family became Christian after immigrating to the U.S., and so I think we learned a new way to deal with these scars that life had given us. And it reminds me of the practice of saving old things and repairing and using them, actually, which is typical of many Asian families that I've come across. So that reminds me of what I learned from my faith, that God doesn't discard worn out people. Grace and mercy override perfection, and difficult parts of our personal stories prepare us for a greater good in the end, so that we don't have to feel ashamed of scars anymore. But yet, I think the tension remains between two values that I do see are common in Asian cultures, which is you want to save face, and you're also frugal. So all of that to say, it was refreshing to make this quilt block and to be reminded of all these things and to proudly display something that's worn out. And for me, it's been really beautiful and powerful to trace back elements of my life across like generations, cultures, and world history, and just find these different connections through this disjointed immigrant experience.